dominant heavyweight we have seen. Incredible cardio. Incredible wrestling.
He is the best heavyweight on the planet Earth as of right now.
That's it. It is all over. Cain Velasquez remains the UFC heavyweight champion.
Injury setbacks have kept UFC heavyweight champion Cain Velasquez on the sideline since late 2013. But the early mornings and long, grueling training days, the types of days that made him champion in the first place, are back in full effect. The Mexican-American champ knows what he must do after what transpired while he was away from the octagon.
Purdue, Hunt, and here we go!
It was definitely hard to watch them both fight.
And it's all over! Fabricio Verdum is the new interim UFC heavyweight champion of the world!
You know, I felt like I needed to be a part of that.
No me gusta cuando la gente habla que es un cinturón de mentiras. Es un cinturón que vale. Voy a demostrar a todos que voy a unificar el cinturón.
Good, okay.
I've been away for too long. I just want to go out there and fight again, and go out there and fight and win.
At UFC 188 in Mexico City, Cain Velasquez and Fabricio Verdum will fight for the right to be called the undisputed UFC heavyweight champion.
Solo puede haber un campeón. Y este campeón soy yo.
I'd love to fight Eddie Alvarez. I know I could beat him. I want to prove it to the world.
I'd love to fight him. I kind of feel like I have to fight him.
He just don't shut up. Every other interview, he's talking about fighting me.
And Gilbert Melendez. And Eddie Alvarez, who have a long-standing feud dating back to before they were in the UFC, get a chance to settle it.
You know, now he's in the UFC, it makes sense. Let's do it.
Sometimes the best fight is the fight that you ran away from. This one, you should have ran away from.
Go inside the lives and training camps of these four elite fighters as they prepare to throw down in Mexico. This is Countdown to UFC 188.
King's MMA is a place to be, you know. We have one of the best coaches in the world, Master Rafael Cordeiro.
I'm very proud of all my team. You know, guys work hard every day. Yes. This team is not just about people training together, it's about family.
Fabricio, he's been at King's MMA for over 6-7 years, and now he's heavyweight and lightweight champion, so it's great for the team.
Yes.
No doubt, King's MMA is currently one of the most successful gyms in the sport, and the cornerstone is none other than Cordeiro himself. He is the man most responsible for molding Verdum into championship material. This was most apparent when Verdum fought Travis Brown in a number one contenders bout last April.
The question is, does he have enough? Does he have the ability to beat this big Hawaiian?
The fight was expected to be closely contested. No one expected Fabricio Verdum to do what he did.
Fabricio with a combination and a kick to the body.
Outstanding.
And this is something that we never expected. Oh, man! Fabricio Verdum mocking Travis Brown and then lighting him up. All striking, all Verdum, all amazing.
Total domination by Verdum.
Verdum would be scheduled to fight heavyweight champion Cain Velasquez at UFC 180 in Mexico City. During camp, Velasquez ruptured his MCL and would be forced to withdraw from the event, leaving Verdum without an opponent and the main event in question.
Cuando me llamó Dan White 3 semanas antes, me hacía una decepción para mí. Claro que sí, me quedé como, ah, no me lo crees, me estoy preparando para este momento tan especial en mi vida. De repente me dijo Dan White, no vas a pelear contra Cain Velasquez, vas a pelear contra Mark Hunt. pero vas a pelear por el título, vas a pelear por el cinturón interino. Y mi profesor Rafael Cordero dijo, vamos a pelear y vamos a pelear con quien sea, no hay problema porque nosotros estamos preparados.
Mark Super Samoan Hunt, the former K-1 Grand Prix champion. He can knock out anyone on this planet.
Y la gente pensaba que Mark Hunt me podría noquear y yo le podría someter. Pero nadie creía que yo iba a noquear a Mark Hunt. Nadie pensaba eso.
Fabricio said openly, if Mark Hunt leaves the opening, he will knock him out.
Back and forth, I'm standing
right
in front of
him. Like that.
Oh my goodness. You can feel the wind over here. Verdum with the counter. Nice knee. Yeah. He got him. Verdum trying to finish. And it's all over. Fabricio Verdum is the new interim UFC heavyweight champion of the world.
Estaba preparado para este momento y justamente agarré el cinturón interino y voy a unificar ese cinturón.
Got up at 6 this morning. It's 6:51 right now. Training at 7 o'clock over in Hollister. It's not too bad. It's a 20-minute drive, but I mean, there's no traffic really or anything. You know, it's smooth all the way through. Today's pretty busy today.
Tony Castro used to Olympic lift, you know, back in the day. He used to do it competitively. So he knows the body, you know, very well. I can come in some days when my body's run down and something's bothering me. He could see it on me before I even tell him. So he knows the body very well. And also, he specializes in the power aspect.
Today we're working on the second pull. It's for his takedowns, so he's more explosive. We want to work the quick twitch fibers in the muscle.
Excellent.
And he does go in for a shoot. He finishes it and he takes the person down. And then, you know, when he relaxes and he throws his hands, he has heavier hands, he has a lot more power.
Okay, you're gonna do another double?
Basically, it saves more gas throughout the fight. If the fight lasts a long time. More explosion through the middle.
I've noticed a big difference. I'm able to feel it in practice. I feel like I am hitting harder. I feel like I am, when I wrestle, I am getting stronger and more powerful.
That's one.
He's stronger, he's more athletic, he's faster.
Good.
He's just a complete athlete right now.
There you go.
Good. This will be definitely the best Cain Velasquez you've ever seen.
That's it for today, guys.
The UFC's first show in Mexico this past November was a huge success. In fact, all 21,000 seats were sold out 8 hours after tickets were made available to the public. And with a Mexican-American heavyweight champion as the headliner, UFC 188 will be even bigger. Between training, Cain's days are filled with TV interviews and photo shoots.
Perfect.
But that won't make him lose focus on the task at hand. And it's straight back to the American Kickboxing Academy for a training session with longtime head coach Javier Mendez, who has been the linchpin to his success.
With Cain, the object goal is always to keep improving on him. You know, from the last fight that the fans have seen him, his technique is actually better now. His mentality is better, how he's gonna approach the fight.
This fight against Verdum, he definitely, you know, with every fight, he improves on his stand-up. So we need to be on point with our striking, and when we go out there and fight him, we need to have that confidence again that we can strike with him.
This fight has to be a statement for Cain Velasquez, for the fans and everybody to understand that the champ's back.
Cain's success can also be attributed to elite level training partners, and none better than UFC light heavyweight champion Daniel Cormier to help him prepare for the unification bout against Verdum.
It's a good matchup. You know, Verdum is very, very tough. He's got great grappling, and his stand-up's improved tremendously. So it'll be a tough fight for Cain, but I believe Cain can get the job done. There's no heavyweight in the world that can actually compete with him. I think that he walks right through him if he fights his fight.
UFC 188 features a title unification bout between heavyweight champion Cain Velasquez and interim champ Fabricio Werdum. Werdum is on a five-fight UFC win streak, which is tops in the heavyweight division.
First man to ever take Travis Brown down.
The Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt feels at home on the ground.
Oh, look at this! This can't be good.
And has 28 takedowns in his last 23 fights. In that time, he has pulled off 8 out of 21 attempted submissions.
He's down it!
Werdum's striking has improved tremendously, and he is landing 4.38 significant strikes per minute. Cain Velasquez, however, leads that category all time, with an impressive number of 6.21. In fact, Velasquez has remarkable numbers in some other categories. He's recorded 3 of the 4 highest striking totals in heavyweight history.
Oh man, those are just rock hard shots.
And his 1,257 total strikes landed are most in the division. The champion's 9 knockouts also put him atop that list. And UFC 188 will mark the true battle between the two best heavyweights right now in the UFC.
Lunes y miércoles y viernes por la tarde siempre voy a UFC Gym. Lioto entrena ahí y me dijo, Werdum, ven a entrenar conmigo, que yo te voy a presentar a un chico que es muy bueno.
Sí.
Y eso hace el levantamiento olímpico.
Use the hips. Go.
Eso.
With the Olympic movements, creates a lot of rate of force development, so that helps out a lot with hip explosion. Not only that, with coordination, speed, and strength. Speed. You need to get your head taller, get more vertical. Okay. Along with the deadlifts, he'll just have a lot of overall strength, a lot of posterior chain work, which is one of the number one things neglected in the physical activities.
Yo nunca pensaba que iba a poder levantar así un peso como este, ¿no?
150. When you're standing up, make sure the knees come back. Very good. One more.
Yo creo que hasta el final de este entrenamiento estaré fuerte como necesite en la pelea.
Strength has been a major focus in this training camp, and Werdum can test his progress outside of the weight room. Training partners are hand-selected. And today, Werdum goes with undefeated pro MMA fighter, Orlando Sanchez.
Orlando Sanchez, él pesa como 270 libras.
Eso.
Yo creo que es muy difícil que yo entrene con una persona más fuerte que Orlando, ¿no?
Eso. Eso.
Cuando entreno con Orlando, yo veo que estoy bien cuando le puedo aguantar a Orlando porque está fuerte como un toro.
There is no heavyweight that's better than Fabricio, you know. His timing, his speed, his strength, everything has changed. I have a lot of respect for Cain, but I believe Fabricio Werdum can finish anybody in the world right now, and I feel that he will finish the fight.
My dad grew up really poor. He only went to school, I think, from first, second, and third grade. He always had that dream of coming to the U.S., you know, getting a better job here, and also raising his family here. As a kid, growing up where I grew up, you know, Yuma, Arizona, it's a border town where 30 minutes from Mexico. The town isn't that big, but a lot of people have a similar background that their family came from Mexico. A lot of them work in the lettuce fields. My parents, you know, always took us to Mexico on the weekends. you know, just to kind of visit family and eat and just kind of know the culture down there. Having that Mexican heritage and being very proud of where I came from, where my parents came from, I carry that now to what I do today as far as fighting. When you think of Mexican boxers, they're very tough. Going forward, a lot of pressure, you know, very exciting. That's what I like about having that Mexican style of fighting.
For this camp, just like the four previous, Velasquez has been working with the most unlikely of trainers.
There you go, whip it, shoulder.
An 81-year-old boxing guru known to the team as Pops.
When you do those kind of combinations, he don't know when you're gonna stop, you understand? Shoot.
Who first trained Javier Mendez many years ago.
That's gonna get him. If that don't get him, the super special will. Oh boy.
I first met Pops in 1985 when I started fighting. And from the very first day I met Pops, he said, boy, you're gonna be a world champion.
I guess he was a real estate agent at that time. He could punch and he could kick like a mule.
Sure enough, I became a two-time world champion for Pops. And he's been my rock, he's been my strength, and he's still the same guy today.
Yeah. Yeah. Dump him.
Pops' focus is all about power.
Yeah, that boy. Dump him.
Every punch that you throw, he wants all the power that you can generate from.
I'm 81 years old. I've been in the business 47 years. That's right, dump. There isn't any fighter, I don't care what the weight they are, that I can't hold mitts for.
I've never seen that. I myself have problems all the time with my elbow. Pops has never had one problem ever. He's a phenom, unbelievable.
Yeah, Pops was one of the guys that helped me a lot when I got my belt back from Dos Santos.
Right away, Kane, very aggressive, much more movement.
I told him, you know, Kane, you're the best heavy-edge puncher that I have ever trained.
Kane Velasquez has shown Junior Dos Santos a whole another level of fighter.
Don't you go out there and embarrass me. You get out there and you kick the hell out of Dos Santos.
Kane went on to pulverize Dos Santos over the course of five rounds.
This is that freak athlete that destroys everyone in the gym.
And since that time, he's looked unbeatable. He crushed Dos Santos again in the trilogy fight.
Right hand by Kane.
Looking to continue his impressive streak and show more of that improved striking against Verdum at UFC 188.
My stand-up is better than his. The confidence, you know, just kind of raised, you know, with me in the stand-up. I can go out there and, you know, just take it to him. You know, I have to.
Cobrinha es uno de los mejores de jiu-jitsu, como 7 u 8 veces campeón mundial. Entonces, siempre que venimos aquí, venimos con mucho gusto, porque Cobrinha es un amigo nuestro de hace mucho. Me está ayudando también de hace bastante tiempo ya con la parte física.
I'm trying to do what we have been doing, which is like the circuit training. It's more like, you know, conditioning for endurance. Kane, he is really well known by his gas tank. He never stops, right? So that's what I've been preparing, like Fabrizio as well. Do the circuit training for work, and then we don't stop.
La primera parte hemos hecho el preparación física y todo eso, ¿no? Pero después la segunda empezamos con entrenamiento de jiu-jitsu, que es muy importante, que la gente piensa que como yo soy cinturón negro de jiu-jitsu, la gente piensa que yo no necesito poner el kimono más allá. Pero yo estoy seguro que tengo que poner el kimono, tengo que estar mejorando cada vez más.
Verdum is a multiple-time world champion himself. And Cobrina believes he is among the top two or three jiu-jitsu fighters in the UFC.
I'll name like, you know, Demian Maia, I'll name Jacare, and I'll name Fabrício Verdum as well. If they get on the ground, I mean, it's still finished.
Entonces tenemos que poner a Cain Velasquez en situaciones diferentes a ver cómo va a reaccionar. No solo yo, pero como todos queremos ver a Cain Velasquez en el suelo. Cómo se va a comportar cuando yo le ponga en el suelo y a ver cómo va a poder defenderse, ¿no?
Verdum's elite ground game is well documented in MMA as well. And perhaps his most notable moment, even today, was when he faced Fedor Emelianenko in Strikeforce.
Here he is, Fedor Emelianenko!
Fedor was 10 years unbeaten and considered by many the best heavyweight in history. He looked invincible. It took Verdum just 69 seconds to say otherwise.
Here comes the triangle choke! Verdum!
Y si tengo que chocar una vez más el mundo, como choqué la vez en 2010 cuando gané a Fedor, lo haré otra vez. Solo puede haber un campeón, y este campeón soy yo.
For this camp, Velasquez has brought in Jamil Kelly, who won the silver medal in freestyle wrestling at the 2004 Olympics.
I want to try to get this guy up as much as possible. I don't want to stay in the middle. So we're going to work one guy, 3 minutes each, just working from your underhooks, your front headlocks, whatever you want to work. Takedowns, all the way to the ground.
Kelly was a member of the U.S. team alongside Daniel Cormier and has great respect for both DC and Kane.
I mean, he's a beast. Him and Daniel both, they probably don't have the, you know, the Brock Lesnar build or look to make you just think that they're so strong, but...
Be aggressive when you get in that position. Know what you want to do when you get there.
They've got really good, strong legs and hips that allow them to finish takedowns against those bigger guys.
Kane, he's good, man, everywhere. Pace. Pushes me like nobody else has ever pushed me in my life. Just keeps coming forward. I can't keep him off of me. Most of the time, I'm the guy that's pursuing. And he makes it play the cat. You know, I'm the mouse.
Move him and control him. Set him on his butt quick. Set him on his butt quick.
He's the best fighter in the world.
Punch combo to a leg attack, okay? Punch combo to a leg attack, running the pipe.
Excited to see Kane back in the octagon after being off for all this time, but knowing the kind of competitor that Kane is, I know that he's going to go out there and put on the show, and I'm really confident that he's going to get his hand raised.
This fight with Cain Velasquez, you know, fighting in Mexico, is extremely special. Especially now that the first time that he was scheduled to fight, it didn't go through, so this one even means more to him.
Live from Mexico City, Mexico!
I was down there for the first fight, and it was just chaos.
The champion, Cain Velasquez, probably the most interested spectator of our main event.
And Cain wasn't even fighting. And so you can imagine what it's going to be like this time around.
Yeah, you know, it's a thing of, I just keep replaying it over and over again in my mind as far as when I walk out there.
Presenting the reigning, defending!
I'm just excited to do that. I'm excited to fight there in front of the Mexican fans.
Heavyweight champion of the world!
It's a big deal for him, big deal for his family. Big deal for the UFC. that I can't wait to be in attendance to watch it. It'll be special.
And in order to unify the UFC heavyweight belts, he must dispatch Fabricio Werdum. But both Velasquez and his team are confident that he will get the job done.
Kane is a different animal, he's a different beast, and he's the champion. He's gonna go show Fabricio that doesn't deserve to be in the cage with him.
I think I'm better than him at everything. Stand up, I'm better than him. I feel like if we go to the ground, he won't put me in any danger at all.
Fabricio is a good fighter, but he's not a champion. You don't become a champion by beating Mark Hunt on 2 weeks' notice. Kane has proved himself as the baddest man on the planet, and he's gonna go out there and he's gonna show it.
To me, it's gonna be like everybody else. The longer it goes with Kane, the worse it goes for you. It's either he's gonna get stopped, or he's gonna get a 5-round beating of his life.
When I joined the UFC, if they would have said, do you want a title shot or would you like to fight Gerald Melendez? In my heart, deep down, I would say, that title shot. I want to fight Gerald Melendez.
I did want to put it out there that I'd love to fight Eddie Alvarez. He's top in the world. Him and I would be a great fight, and it would bring me a lot of respect when I beat him, you know?
Eddie and I have both been some of the most popular 155-pounders outside the UFC, you know, for a long time.
He started almost the same year I started. Very similar record, similar style.
For a long time, I was a champion in Strikeforce.
And still, the Strikeforce lightweight champion of the world, Gilbert El Niño.
Eddie was the champ in a different organization, and you know, we're the two biggest 155 pounders outside of the UFC.
Ground and pound, and this one's over.
You know, at times, debatably, he was number one, I was number one, one and two, one and two.
In 2010, both fighters had cleared out the lightweight division in their respective organizations. And Gilbert Melendez sought out the biggest fight against the best fighter that he could find outside the UFC. That was Eddie Alvarez.
He seems like to be the man outside the UFC right now to beat.
After I'd make a headline, he'd right away say he wanted to fight me, try to steal a headline.
I know I could beat him, man, and I want to find out, and I want to prove it to the world.
And also, I think it'd mean a lot for the lightweight division, you know what I mean? And I'd love to fight him. I kind of feel like I have to fight him.
I wanted to fight him, and I wanted to make it happen. You know, and I want to fight him out of respect. I think the guy's tough, you know? He took it as an insult.
I'm like, what are you doing, man? Make your own headline. He's like a high school cheerleader, always trying to the quarterback.
Gilbert's telling the world that he wants to fight me. He just don't shut up. Every other interview he's talking about fighting me. I want to fight Eddie Alvarez.
You know, why is he calling me out if this can't happen, this fight can't happen? You know, I thought it could happen. That's why I said it. I just didn't say it for giggles.
Two shots to the ground.
Sometimes he didn't say the brightest things.
The feud continued for years with both fighters wanting a piece of each other.
It's a fight that the fans been looking forward to a while, something that me and Gilbert talked about for a long while, and like I said, it's one of them fights that the stakes are high and people want to see it.
But the rival promotions couldn't come to an agreement, and it was unclear whether the fight would ever happen. Melendez debuted in the UFC in April of 2013, and just over a year later, Alvarez would follow. And with two of the top lightweights of our generation under the same banner, talks about making the fight heated up again in February.
You know, if Eddie Alvarez is out there, we should finally make a date and we should try to fight each other. Finally, you know, if this is really gonna happen, you know, then let's finish it. I really wanna hit this guy.
Blue corner. Eddie
Now we're in the same promotion. Now it's gonna happen, and now he's gonna get what he wants, and he's gonna be sorry that he ever asked for it.
I'll be there with my mouthpiece, and I'll be there with my hands up. I'll be ready to throw down.
Now that Gilbert Melendez and Eddie Alvarez are fighting under the UFC banner, a bout between two of the top lightweights of this generation can finally happen.
He is a ferocious fighter, and he's got some of the best ground and pound I've ever seen.
Melendez entered the UFC in 2013.
Gilbert Melendez has fought the best of the best available outside of the UFC.
But Eddie Alvarez is a promotional newcomer. Now, the four-time MMA champion has his sights set on a fifth title, the biggest one there is.
There's not a doubt in my mind I'll be UFC champion. I don't put a time limit. I'll simply be champion because I won't stop until I am. It's inevitable. Things will align because of the things that I do every day. I just won't stop until I do. I've always been that way, and I'm gonna continue to be that way.
Tuesdays are our MMA sparring day. We try to raise the intensity up.
5 minutes, let's go, work!
We're allowed to go 100%. Rarely do we get to do that during the week, but Tuesday we have the green light.
130, Michael.
Me and Mike Johnson have been training together since I came to the Black Zanes. When two people are like-minded and they sort of are on the same path, they sort of attract each other, and they you know, they want to make each other better.
Go! Round number two!
Hey, good timing. Having, you know, Eddie here as a training partner is incredible. I still think that he's one of the best lightweights in the world, if not the best lightweight. You know, I've always said that.
30 seconds, go!
He's a guy who will get in there and go into the later rounds and push hard.
Gary, you work here, Eddie. Nothing comes easy right here. Nothing's easy. Make him earn everything. Good.
I'm looking forward to like a high-paced, violent fight. I want fans to get excited. I want them to jump up and feel something when I'm in there.
130. Just make your feet move. Dance on a little bit.
There was long time talk about these two guys fighting each other because of the similar styles they have. They go for fights, they brawl. Go, be fast in the last round. Go, Eddie.
Going into this fight, I feel like he has no shot. He's gonna do his best, but he's gonna come up short. If he dares to go in the center of the cage and throw the punches that he normally throws with other lightweights, I will end him right in the center of the octagon.
Now Eddie's saying if I stand toe-to-toe with him, it's gonna be a, you know, he's gonna knock me out, and you know, I don't have the guts to stand toe-to-toe with him. It's not gonna take much convincing for me to stand toe-to-toe and bang it out with Eddie Alvarez, not much at all. So if he wants it, I'll be there.
For 7 years, he was the king of Strikeforce.
Since coming to the UFC.
Oh, big vicious knee to the body.
Gilbert Melendez has shown fans what he's all about.
Big right hand by Melendez.
He's been in some battles.
They're gonna swing to the finish.
Oh my God.
Unbelievable.
Oh my God.
Whoa.
And always puts on exciting fights. And Melendez, the number four lightweight in the world, hasn't lost focus on what he came to the UFC to do.
I feel like I've been in the sport for a long time. I've been relevant for a long time. I've been top 10 for almost 10 years. I've been the champion of WBC. I've been the champion of Strikeforce. I've defended titles. I fought 25-minute fights.
up there. I'm covered. Finish it right.
I see fighters come and go, champions win and lose and disappear, and I'm always relevant, and I take pride in that. My goal, for sure, is to just put on a great show and beat Eddie Alvarez. You know, I think there's some guys out there that are very beatable, and I think the champion is beatable. We've seen him lose. I think everyone's beatable, and it's up for grabs. So, you know, I'm gonna keep doing my thing, and hopefully I get that shot.
For sparring, Gilbert has brought in a number of fighters for this camp. Today, it's Kareem Mayfield.
Hey, Lewis.
Mayfield is a former pro boxing champion with a 19-2 record. He's known for his heavy hands and has knocked out 11 men inside the boxing ring.
Keep your range.
Today, it's not about MMA.
30 seconds. Pop.
It's just straight boxing.
Ah, good job, guy.
Don't do too big, though. Like, what? Tap, and then bang, bang, and out. Tap, bang, bang, and out.
Kareem Mayfield, he's a scrappy guy who throws big bombs like Eddie Alvarez.
Pop. Nine, change the level too. Pop. Nine, do that again like that.
A lot of times boxers think that MMA guys' hand skills aren't that up to par, but you got guys like Gil Melendez.
Pop.
His skill, his hand game is up to par for sure.
Last one. Nine, that's it. Get out there.
This fight totally has the potential to be fight of the night, fight of the year.
Change the level a bit.
I'm stepping in the octagon, I'm fighting a guy who's a beast, a guy who's gonna come forward, a guy who likes to sling him, a guy who's been dropped and who's got back up, a guy who's been a champion, a guy who's fought 25 minutes.
Last minute. Keep it tight now.
This forces me to get prepared. You know, this forces me to be ready.
Beautiful.
And when you put two bulls in the center of the octagon, you know, it's about to go down. So I anticipate this being, you know, a crazy one.
It's good. Good.
Recently, my family moved back to Philadelphia, so now I came back here to Florida on my own. I stay at a fighter house. I live with guys who are doing the same exact thing I'm doing. Everyone's like-minded, everybody wants to be champions, and we all stay here and eat, sleep, and fight.
I'm gonna saute these sweet potatoes in coconut oil and burn them. Tastes good, burn.
Although I'm ultra prepared for fights when I come down here on my own and I'm ready to go in, it's not just who I am. I'm more than just a fighter. I'm a father, I'm a husband, so it's tough for me on the weekends and times where I know I have downtime. Whenever I'm not training, I'm either resting or eating, but I just try to keep moving and not keep still while I'm here.
And that's how it's done. How was your day, anyway?
Good, I ran. How was yours?
Good, rested a little bit. I'm a little scraped up. Hey, I have something that looks like a hickey, but it's not.
My family's everything to me. I have four children, I have a wife, and my family's most important to me. Fighting is just it's a way of me supporting my family.
I might go back again at like 4:30 to get some, like an hour in before I get on a plane. I fly back to Philadelphia tonight, so I will see you.
I know. That little jar is gonna pick you up. What time are you coming in?
I get in.
Send me all your info.
I'll send it to you. I'll see you tonight.
Yay. Love you.
I love you. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
I fight, I get a big check, and I do really cool with my family, and I think I rinse and repeat. I think it's a good life. I have nothing to complain about.
For Alvarez's opponent, Gilbert Melendez, fighting in Mexico is something he's been looking forward to for a long time.
Fighting in Mexico City is somewhat of a dream come true. You know, I never thought the UFC would be in Mexico City, and now here they are for their second show. This show's huge. You know, because Kane is the main event now, and now I'm on it. You know, I'm a co-main event, so You know, this is the motherland. That's where my blood is from. You know, I'm proud to be Mexican. I'm proud of my roots.
That's what Mexicans do. We hold our ground and we fight. I'd rather go down on my shield than run in circles.
You know, my dad was born in Mexico, and you know, he's just the proudest Mexican I know. You know, he grew up in Tijuana, so I feel like I get an opportunity to make him proud. And you know, when I win, I'm gonna dedicate the fight to him.
I honestly think this is the biggest matchup in the lightweight division.
Drop.
Regardless of who's champion, who's not champion.
Now we're both in the UFC. Now we're here full circle, and you know, our path's been waiting for years, and now it's happening. It's gonna be on my home turf out there in Mexico, and I'm gonna get the job done.
Work, Eddie. I think the Mexicans will be disappointed in their Mexican, because he's gonna try to make this fight the fight that they don't wanna see by grappling and trying to stop me from fighting.
I fight, dude. I always come to fight. You know, you've seen any of my fights. You know, I'm always, you know, fight of the night. I've been fight of the year. When he starts saying stuff like this, it just leads me to believe that he's delusional. I don't think he's the brightest guy, and I actually think that's gonna make the difference in this fight, you know, and I think I'll enjoy punching him as well.
It's one of them things like curiosity killed the cat. He wanted to see how he'd do against me, he wanted to fight me. Maybe sometimes the best fight is the fight that you ran away from. This one, he should have ran away from.
Every fight out there is tough, but I ain't scared of nobody. I have too much guts, dude. I'm scared to quit, you know what I mean? I'm not gonna back down. And I'm not talking out of my ass, you know, like he is. I got my together, I know what's gonna happen, and you know, I'm chalking up a good game plan, and I'm gonna beat this guy.
At UFC 188, these two lightweights will get to settle the score several years after their feud began. And Cain Velasquez is finally ready to make his return to the octagon.
Going into this fight, you know, I don't feel like I need to make a statement, you know? I know what to do out there. I just have to go out there and do it.
He will take on Fabricio Werdum, and the two men will enter the octagon in Mexico City and compete for the right to be called undisputed.
Lo que tengo de a lo mejor puede ser de especial de corazón. No solo estoy para pelear, para ser otro más. Yo quiero ser uno más. Yo quiero ser el mejor del mundo. Voy a ganar a Cain Velasquez.